always find this out. I don't say because I'm happy. I'm happy because I say.
Good morning, daddies. Good morning, mommies. Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
Navigator of this flagship of knowledge to address us.
sir, please.
Of today's evening, Mr. Narayan Pati, Madam Subrata Pati, Headmistress Mrs. Misra, parents, my colleagues, dear students, ladies and gentlemen, we are very much honored today due to the gracious presence of Mr. and Mrs. Pati, who do not require any kind of introduction. And that, in spite of their busy schedule, they are present here today to shower their blessings on our tiny tots. We are indeed very fortunate, and I express my gratitude to both of you, sir and madam. Now, parents, you have put a lot of confidence on us. You have given your small kids to us. Maybe they are of the age of 3 or 3.5 years. It is just like you have given a sapling. You have a lot of confidence on us to make them into a banyan tree. And with full confidence, I assure you that we will come up to your expectation. But as a principal, I would also expect certain things of you all. Normally, what happens, a parent expects a lot from the children, from their words, and they want their left brain to function. Normally, out of ignorance, they do not think about the right brain. They want them to do well in mathematics. They want them to speak well. They want to have a very good vocabulary. They want, you know, to do all well in academics. But look, if they do well in academics, then they will get good marks throughout. But maybe they will be failure in the examination which they will face on a daily basis after they come out of schools and colleges. And time has come now to give them proper training so that they, after passing out from the schools and colleges, when they actually start their life, when they will start earning, when they will be facing their examination on a daily basis, in that examination they should be successful. They should have a great organizing ability. They should have confidence on them. They should love themselves. They should know how to adapt in the society. They should know how to, you know, bear insult and injury. And if they learn all these art, then in the examination of life, they will become successful. And one more thing, and those skills actually we are teaching, and I am very lucky because I have a very good team of dedicated, young, talented teachers, those who are grooming your words. In between, somebody, you know, sent a story in WhatsApp, and that I want to share with you. It is just like this. A primary school teacher gave a topic to the children that if you want, what wish do you want from God? And the children wrote stories, and the primary teacher took all the answer scripts, and at home he started correcting. And with one child's wish, he got very emotional and started weeping. And that time her husband came and asked and sat beside her and said, "What happened?" So the primary school teacher is saying, you know, to her husband that you see, read this essay. And the husband read that essay, and the child has written that, God, you make me into a TV, because my parents, after coming back home, they sit in front of the TV and they spend all the time, they laugh, they make all kind of merriment, they enjoy only in front of the TV. They never shout at the TV, they never thrash the TV, they never slap the TV, and they enjoy. And that time I see my parents are very happy. And when the TV goes out of order, then also TV has its own importance. They call mechanic, they are very much worried the TV should be all right. So if I become a TV, then I can draw the attention of my father and mother, and they will start loving me, and you know, I will also be very happy seeing my parents happy. Then after that, from the husband's eye also tears came out. He said, you see, the child is suffering from loneliness, and how are his parents? Then the mother replies, you know, that primary school teacher replies, it is our own child, it is our own daughter. See, who has written this essay. So why I want to say you, because you see, gone are those days. My grandfather used to have, say, maybe about 8 to 12 children. And then, you know, next, you know, our father says, maybe about 4 to 6 children. Our is maybe about 2 to 3 children. Now your is maybe about 1 or 2. Now you see, the children are suffering from loneliness. Earlier in our days, we were sharing all our emotions and everything with our, you know, brothers and sisters. But now it is not so. The child wants to share his feelings or her feelings with only the parents. So you have to give emotional support. And if we cannot give that kind of emotional support, the child will be helpless. And you know, the growth will hamper. So these things you have to take care. And you also see to this that the child, you know, overcomes the shyness. And nowadays, gone are those days when we were going only for the government jobs. Now you need that, you know, what is expected, that they will get job in some multinational company, some corporate house, where you require everything from the child. The marketing skill, the communication skill, the organizing ability, ability to absorb shock, because then you don't know, anytime they will be fired. And what comes, you do not know. So those type of skills we have to teach them, otherwise life will be horrible for them. And you are very fortunate, and because you have put your words in DPS, and with confidence I am telling you, you will feel proud when your children will pass plus 2 or 10th from here. But equally, we also expect of you certain things. The school is growing. We have a very supportive management. We have very good parents, very good teachers, and I am fortunate to be the principal of the school. So that way the school is growing. And you'll be happy to see the performance of our children. And when you see the performance of our children, you'll be really impressed with the kind of training we are giving. I wish all the best for those who will be performing here. And at the end, I again welcome our chief guest and all those who are present here to encourage our small kids. Thank you.
And I am sure that none of would give their valuable time to them. Am I justified, parents? Yes or no? Thank you. May I request Madam Subrata Pati, President NYCA and an eminent author, to come to the dais and felicitate our young buds. I request our headmistress, ma'am, Mrs. Girija Nandini Mishra, to come to accompany her. Ma'am, please.
I would like to tell you something. It's just an add-on. Though they are the youngest in the school, the nursery wing is the youngest in the school, but we have 100% attendance today. A huge round of applause for them. Thank you. Now I hand over the mic to Swati ma'am for the announcement of
Tiny Dipsites. Our tiny tots have proved their talent in all the streams, and to appreciate them is our duty. So let's give a huge round of applause for the future Shakespeares and George Alrights, who have impressed us with their awesome grip on English vocabulary. And here are the names of the top achievers. Here comes Arunima Sahu, beauty with brains. Rakshit Sutar, a versatile genius. Yes, parents, please keep on applauding and encouraging your child. Akib Muhammad Khan, the boy with brains and bronze. Parents, please keep on applauding. Please. Next, here comes Shreya Sharanya. She may be the future Anita Desai. And parents, please give a huge round of applause to Shreya Sharanya once again, because she is one of the topmost achievers in cultural activities too. Yes, here next comes Om Prakash Barik, a matchless gem. Coming up next year, Sanvi Maharana. Here comes again Sanvi Maharana, a charming girl. Next comes here Sataakshi Biswal, who is smart and savvy. Next here, Adhav Jha. He is a mix of charm and charisma. So, moving on to the next category, let's put our hands together to welcome the next generation of Shakuntala Devi, Aryabhatta and Ramanujan. Thus, the next area of excellency is in the field of mental ability. And the names of the toppers are Shubham Panda, the brainy boy. Here comes the next, Prisha Sabat, the most intellectual. Yes, followed by Ahana Mohanty, our very own human calculator. Parents, please keep on applauding and encouraging your child, please. Anshuman Bhara, the dexterous. Yes, here followed by Anshuman Naik, blessed with analytical power. Here again comes Suniksha Das, who is very much logical. Yes, next, Rishik Bhuyan, a boy with a critical, keen mind. Followed by Aradhya Barik, who is too much competent. Now comes to the next category. Let's move to the next area of eminence, which involves the name of the dynamos with scientific temperament and keen interest in environment. Be allowed and give a huge round of applause for the expertise of this field. And here comes Satyajit Malik, who is very innovative. Please, parents, keep on applauding, please. Suryansh Das, the naturalist. Next comes Pragyan Kishan, the ecologist. Next, Ashish Kumar Gora, the compassionate. Followed by Abhijit Malik, very sociable. Tanima, the resplendent. Here, the next one, Divyanshi Tulsian, very idealistic girl. And last but not the least, Shivam Bhaskar Gupta, the contemplative.
Thank you.
Thank you, our respected madams, for giving such your encouraging support to our tiny tots.
Now,
may I humbly request our honorable chief guest, Mr. Naren Pathy, ex-GM of RSP and senior industry relation advisor, NIT Rourkela, to kindly come on the stage and give away the prize to find ourselves. The principle of a true art is not to portray but to evoke, and here we present our future artist, the first wire, Ved Prakash Samal, the magnificent. Next comes here, Arshwan Rao, the innovative.
Sonali Mahapatra.
Here, followed by Sonali Mahapatra, the lively girl. Parents, please again give a huge round of applause for Sonali Mahapatra, as she is again one of the achiever in creativity. Please, parents, keep on applauding, please. It's a humble request to you all. Next, Sajal Khandelwal is the most energetic one, and parents, please once again hear it for Sajal Khandelwal, as he is again one of the winner in cultural activities. Parents, please keep on applauding, please, it's a sincere request to you all, please encourage your child.
Anvesha Sethi.
Yes, followed by Anvesha Sethi, the enterprising. Next, followed by Devanshi Bhoi, the adorable. And next, Saina Alam, the incredible. Coming up next is your Prisha Shabat, the articulate. Proceeding with the next category of merit, it's in the arena of creativity. And here, the nimble fingers of a budding artist have created magic with papers. So let's welcome the names of the perfectionists of this area. First comes here, Maghavan Behra, the inventive. Yes, here comes Maghavan Behra.
Cheers, please.
Shriyashri Mohanty, the eccentric genius. Coming up next is...
Oh, okay.
Divit, the resourceful. Coming up next is Sai Sohan Bhajana, the innovative. Next comes here Ayush Biswal, the meticulous. Parents, please keep on clapping. They are your kids. Please encourage them. Please. Next comes here Arshi Singh. She is very much imaginative. See the pretty girl. The next is Shivani Upadhyay, the Ignatius. The next category is of dance and music, and it's the hidden language of our soul. The truest expression of a people is in its dance and music. Last but not the least, how can we forget our young, entertaining, growing talents of stage? So the last category of achievers is in the field of cultural activities, and the names are here Anusha Samal, the energetic ones. The next comes here Tamanna Naik, very much lively. Next here comes Sai Shri Sethi, the perfectionist girl. Coming up next is Swastik Sau, the enthusiastic ones. And here is the last one, Sara Surya, much magnificent.
She has been lost.
And here once more, Dibyanga Das, the expressionist. Thank you very much, sir, for your staunch support and encouragement to our little bright future stars. It's over to Rosalina.
You deliver few words to our audience, sir, please.
Sri Mishra, Srimati Pati sitting here, respected teachers, dear parents, and my lovely children. I am really feeling proud to enter to this colorful premises today. And after reaching here, I thought as if a nice rainbow is here. So many colors, so many variety of dresses, and the novel way of greeting the guest. Really, the school is excellent. And what is excellence today? You parents are seeing the excellence part of the school, and I have seen the formative days of the school and the inconvenient part, and in spite of that also, the fast track moving of the school that is taking the school, the glory, the height, the appreciation all around. You have done a very nice thing by putting your child here, and you will be a proud parent, and you will also see that when the courses are over and your son or daughter has passed out from the school and has gone to the society, he will be a respectable citizen. And the Delhi Public School, the brand itself and the style itself and the education they impart, the infrastructure and the etiquette and the culture, there is a driving force for your child to go much ahead, and he can swim, he can think big, and he is a big kid now. When you have left your child here, just think that he is a big kid. He is not a big man or big woman, but he is a big kid. He or she is a big kid. And be proud that your child is here. Your neighbors, your society, they will admire you that how nice decision you have taken. I swear that there is no school comparable to Delhi Public School in the nearby region. So this is a great decision that you have taken. And I, whatever performance I have seen, the children, the tiny tots, I thank the teachers, the music teacher, and the performance they have depicted here, and the parents, because you have also major role here, that some preparation, making dresses, and sending the child here. But I will also tell certain things which is attributed towards parents, towards teachers, and towards the children also, that how they become the good citizen. Because everybody says, maybe political leaders, maybe bureaucrats, maybe teachers, and everybody says that our children will be the best citizen of the country and the citizen of the country who mold the nation, and these children will do something which is miraculous, and they will do something for the betterment of the nation. And nation building process comes from these children. So what they will do, what they will learn here, what is the role of parents, what is the role of teachers, and what is the role of children themselves? It is a big question that how the children, they have been built up in your own house. Now they have been left in the school. So building of the children in the house, building of the children in the school itself, there are many things common, but so many things are to be taught in the school, and so many things are to be done by the parents. So the behavioral part, that the school, even if the school can teach some behavioral part, but the parents have got a major say and major role on the behavioral part of the children. So how the child will behave well, what will the creativity, what will the innovativeness, and what the child will do in the house. Even some parents, they say that my child should not do anything, everything will be done by my wife or by the helping hand or the maid. But certain things which are educative and what are to be done by the child in the later stage, if you do not teach now, then the later stage will never come. So even if the toilet habits, even if how to take bath, even if that if the guest is coming to the house, how to greet, and even if supposing how to smile, how to speak, and what to speak, and supposing you are going to a marriage function, many times you might see that the your daughter is coming and holding you in a very, clinging to you and not going anywhere. What to teach the child that when you are going to a function, that the child is holding you, hugging you and not going anywhere. And what type of education or behavioral part you will tell the child, that the child goes, mixes everywhere. Supposing I have come here and the child sees me tomorrow in another function somewhere in Brahmani Club or German Club or any major function, the child, if he comes and tells me, uncle, you had come to our school and you told like this and I was dancing before you, you gave me the prize, this type of interaction, the child normally they do not do. It is your job that how to inculcate such a spirit that the child must have some extracurricular activities and talking like this and behavioral part also, that should come from you. The rest part can come to the school. The school teachers, they will not force upon the students, nor they will do it in a harassing way that the child will read like this, the quantity of reading like this, the quantity of books or something, that nothing can be forced upon the children. Anything which has come from you, that behavioral part, it carries on, if certain amendments may take place, but it carries on. And many things are to be told. That moral education, even if they learn from the school, but moral things come from the school, house. Even if when somebody is speaking lie, somebody is speaking a mistake, it comes to the mind of the child. And what is learnt in the childhood continues forever. So if you want to make a change in between, it is very difficult to make a change. So anything in the formative period of life, whatever you want to do, I am talking psychological part, that whatever you want to do as a parent, you must do it in such a way that the psychology of the child must not be disturbed. I will tell you certain things, that how the compassion, carefulness, and how things of gratitude. Supposing somebody has helped you, then how the gratitude is to be expressed. The gratitude is the most important thing in the life. So there is, I can tell you a small story, that one postman came to hand over a letter to your house. Not your house, somebody's house. And the postman is telling, letter, 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 but nobody is responding. Then the postman got angry. The postman got angry and asked, that why nobody is coming, I am holding the letter. Then somebody told from the house, from inside, that you can put the letter near the gate. You can put the letter near the gate. But the postman again angry and shouting, that the letter is a registered letter, it is not ordinary letter, I cannot throw the letter like this. You must put your signature and take the letter. Then one child is coming and she is not having legs. She is not having legs. The purpose of what telling was that the child was replying like that, that is because she is not able to walk properly, she doesn't have legs. So the anger of the postman, that the person is not coming from the house, not taking the letter, and the wastage of time by the postman was angry. But when the lady, when the child signed and took the registered letter, that the child saw that the postman was not wearing the shoes. So the compassion from both sides, that the postman saw that the anger, that the person is not coming and taking the letter, their anger, that repentance, it has been converted to repentance. And in that repentance, then the other side is telling that the postman is not having any shoes and walking barefooted. So the child immediately thought that how to provide a shoe to that postman. Then in an occasion, the child provided the shoes. But the postman, when he went to the post office and asked the headmaster, head postmaster, that this is the situation, I got angry. I saw the child was not having the legs and locomotor disability. Now we say it is vinakshama. But I got a gift from the child that she has given me shoes. But I don't have any face to look at the child. That is because I committed a mistake by getting angry. But the child gave a return gift, and that gift was so painful that the child has given me the shoes, but I cannot give the legs. The child is not having the legs, but I cannot provide the legs. So this type of compassion from both sides, it should happen in our family life, in the society, in the school itself. We are losing compassion. We are getting impatient. We are getting angry. All these things, qualities should be something, it should not exist at all. So what is to be learnt in the house from the parents is that provide some opportunity that the child has to be accommodative, has to be careful, has to have compassion, has to have something choices. Sometimes what happened recently, you are looking at the TV, that one farmer is crying with the hand at the in his cheek. They're crying that something, the water is not coming out, something, and farming is not possible. Then the little girl is going, Papa to humko kuch nahi bolte hain, Papa to humko kuch nahi bolte hain. Ab agar Papa humko bolte hain, to hum kuch kar sakte hain. Thik hai, Papa nahi bolte hain, to main bhi karke dikhata hun. Then how the water came, something she did with the intelligence input from the school, that water came out and there was good farming. So that is coming nowadays in TV, there's a good ad. But that speaks a volume that the parents, even if they think that they are the most intelligent creature in the world, and the child is the stupid one, if they feel, that is a total mistake. Sometimes children are more and more clever than the parents. So sometimes in decision making process also, include these children in the decision making process. Hum to kabhi kabhi dekhte hain ghar mein, my wife asking my daughter, aaj kya khaoge, aaj kya banaoge. So I will request यू पेरेंट्स दैट कीप ए पर्टिकुलर डे सोमवार हो जो मैंने वेजिटेरियन किंबा जो बुधवार हो जो मैंने नॉन वेजिटेरियन दैट डू समथिंग समथिंग इनोवेटिव फूड आस्क योर चिल्ड्रेन दैट मैंने क्या करने से होगा क्या करने से होगा क्या खाना खाओगे समथिंग दैट मीन्स द चाइल्ड शुड ईगरली वेट फॉर दैट डे कि आज मम्मी क्या खाना बनाएंगे मम्मी आज क्या खाना बनाएंगे तो हफ्ता में अगर नया नया खाना बनता है एथर चितो पिठा आर थर को कौन आरिसा पिठा तार थर को दोसा तार थर को कौन समथिंग द चाइल्ड शुड बी इन डार्क दैट व्हाट इज हैपनिंग ऑन फूड दैट इज समथिंग इनोवेटिव समथिंग न्यू दैट मीन्स ईगरली वेटिंग इट हैपेंड इन माई हॉस्टल डेज फ्रॉम क्लास सिक्स टिल आई वर्कड इन राउरकेला स्टील प्लांट I was staying in the hostel. So which day you will get egg, which day you will get mutton, which day you will get fish, it was a dark thing to you and it is a surprise. When you go to the dining table, then you find that this has happened. So that means you feel something extremely happy and jolly that this has happened. Anyway, I should not go much beyond this thing. But kabhi kabhi kya hota hai, two friends are sitting, happy life. They, as if today in the Delhi Public School is a happy life. Happy, rejoicing, that nice function, children, parents, teachers, everybody is here, dancing, all good activities are happening. These are called positive activities in the school. No classroom business today, no, kisi ko daantna nahi hai, kisi ko homework kiya hai ki nahi, bolna nahi hai. Aaj pura happy day, like that, one boy and one girl, they are talking each other, ki aaj humara happy moment ka baare mein baat karenge. Kya happy moment hai? Then this girl is telling, the boy is telling that I have a friend that is my happy moment. I have got a friend I can talk to him. It is a happy moment. Then girl is telling I remember about my mom and dad. This is a happy moment for me. Then the other one is telling that I can see the TV. That is a happy moment for life. Then the another child is telling that I can make a drawing and painting. That is a happy moment for me. So happy moments are there. There are certain common things are there, but happy moments gives lot of happiness to parents, teachers, and now principal was telling, I am a parent of this thing. My child was reading here. Principal was asking me, where is your son nowadays? I said he is working in Jindal Steelworks in Bellary, Karnataka. That is the biggest steel plant in the country, and he is making a name for a Prime Minister Trophy. All these things, he is making a presentation. Then the principal said that it can happen because he is your son. I said, no, it cannot happen like that. It could happen because he was your student. So, three cheers to the principal and teacher for Delhi Public School that bachchon ko padhana hai, to Delhi Public School mein padhai hai. The brand is so clear, transparent, and the moment, that happy moment when he goes to an interview and he asks, where you were reading, CBSE or ICSE? No, CBSE. Where? Delhi Public School. Then matter ends there and he's a successful guy. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir, for keeping him to come to the stage. Ma'am, please. We are really happy to have Mr. Karunakar, the member of the governing body of Delhi Public School, among us. We welcome you, sir. May I request Principal Sir to come to the stage. Sir, please. On behalf of Delhi Public School, Raul Killa, here is a small token of love for you.